Hello again, everybody. I'm Michael Cole, and back in the hot seat this week, WWE COO Triple H. Last week, NXT General Manager John Bradshaw Layfield was here to talk about NXT Arrival.
Yes, and he was, and actually I read your tweet about that, about my inexcusable reasons for not being here. Cole, I would be remiss to remind you that you were with me in Orlando, Florida, right? You know how busy I was putting on a very successful, I might add, NXT Arrival special live on the WWE Network. I was just too busy last week, nothing else.
What I meant by the tweet was I thought it was sort of convenient that you weren't here the week that Daniel Bryan challenged you to a WrestleMania match. You've always said that I can ask you whatever questions I want in this forum as long as I'm respectful.
Absolutely. You want to ask your little Daniel Bryan questions, please?
I'd like to.
Feel free.
Let's start. You laid out a lot of different reasons this past Monday night for not giving Daniel Bryan a match at WrestleMania. What's the true underlying reason?
You want me to run the whole list? Or you want me to just start at the top? How about the fact that I'm the COO of this company? The fact that I'm very busy? I don't have time.
No disrespect, and sorry for the interruption, but you've had very high-profile matches in the past while being CEO of the company, so I don't know how this differs.
Yeah, so let me get this straight. You're going to compare The Undertaker and Brock Lesnar, A-plus players, you're going to compare them to a challenge by Daniel Bryan. It's a world of difference. I don't know how many times I have to say that. He's a B-plus player. It's going to take a whole hell of a lot more than Daniel Bryan for me to take the time out of my day and my schedule, my life, my dedication to the WWE Universe to get me to lace up my boots at WrestleMania.
How long are you going to be able to deny what the WWE fans want? Chicago, Monday night on Raw, it was thunderous. They want Daniel Bryan versus Triple H at WrestleMania. It's not just in Chicago. It's every arena we go to in this country and around the world. They want to see that match. How can you not give that to the WWE fans?
There's no denying the fact that they want it. There's no denying the fact that Daniel Bryan thinks he wants it. Careful what you wish for. Imagine that as loud, as thunderous, as crazy, and as deafening as Monday night was in that ring with those people cheering for Daniel Bryan, imagining the deafening silence when he is stopped, embarrassed, and humiliated in front of the world on the grandest stage of them all, Michael. I'm trying to protect them from themselves.
Okay, then if that is what's going to happen in your mind, then why not end it at WrestleMania? Put the Daniel Bryan yes movement to rest once and for all.
Why would I bother? He's a B-plus player. That's pretty good. He's good for business. Me ending it all of that, the T-shirt sales, the movement, all of it, why would I want to end that? It's not good for business. What's best for business is for Daniel Bryan to do his little B-plus shtick over here and do his thing.
I think it would
let the immortals be at the showcase of the immortals. And what do you think, this is my first barbecue? You think this is the first time a guy tries to call me out to ride my coattails into WrestleMania?
Wouldn't it be best for business though, Hunter, if Daniel Bryan beat you in the Superdome and there were 80,000 people? Imagine this, 80,000 people doing this.
Yeah, and let me ask you, in that version of your world, and the flyby earlier in the day by the military, are they flying monkeys or are they flying pigs? Let's live in the real world. He's a 185-pound sawed-off midget, right? I'm gonna get in the ring with him. If I wanted to end it, I would just fire him. I'm not gonna embarrass and humiliate the guy in front of the world. He has value. The people love the little guy. I'm gonna give him that. They do. They have no idea what they're asking for.
Hunter, are you scared of Daniel Bryan?
Michael, honestly?
Everyone, and I mean everyone that I have spoken with, believes that you are afraid of Daniel Bryan.
So you want to know if I'm afraid of him? The answer to your question is the exact same answer to Daniel Bryan's question. though.